Oscar is our funny swimmer, and he does so for a couple of reasons. One is that he's missing his back flippers. He has a little stump for his back left flipper, and he's missing his back right flipper entirely. He was hit by a boat propeller twice when he was very young, once on his right side and once at the very back of his shell. And because of those injuries, his tail and his back right flipper had to be amputated. He has a stump for the back left one, and that actually was an injury that happened before his run-in with the boat, where another fish or a shark or something got a hold of him. And so he had kind of a rough start in life. When sea turtles go to sleep, they don't sleep all night like we do. They go down to the bottom and take a nap, but they have to hold their breath the whole time they're sleeping, so they'll sleep for an hour or so. When they wake up, they come up, they just kind of hang out at the surface, float around for a little while, get several good breaths. Those times when they are just hanging out at the surface, either before or after a big nap, they're a little bit vulnerable to boats that come by that probably don't see them until it's too late. And then they get hit, and those boat propellers is the issue. Those can tear up a sea turtle shell pretty bad. Sometimes turtles that get hit by boats, it causes other issues with their nervous system sometimes, and sometimes, like in his case, with the digestive system. He has a gas bubble that he just can't pass, so that makes his rear end float. It's commonly called bubble butt syndrome. In some cases, it can be very problematic for the turtles. It can make them so that they're stuck at the surface of the water and not able to dive down and get to the food. In Oscar's case, it's really very minor. So you will see as he swims, when he's swimming and he's fishing with those real powerful front flippers, he kind of levels out, but then when he stops, that rear end just starts to creep up a little bit. We do get questions about Oscar pretty regularly, even when he's up swimming around, because it does look a little bit funny, especially when you can see it side by side with Stewie's nice, even glide that is very stereotypical sea turtle swimming motion. We've decided that since he's kind of learned how to deal with the fact that he has a floating butt and just learn to get on with life, that we just leave him alone and let him do it. Anytime you have to handle a sea turtle, they don't really enjoy that, so it's very stressful for him, so we decided that it was not worth, that it would make things worse for him to have us catching him and sticking weights on him than to just leave him alone and let him do it.